Are you the one who is planning to step into web development and don't know where and how to start? So here's an introductory web development session for you guys, mainly focused on what is HTML. So good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Atul, and on the behalf of Edureka, I welcome you guys to this YouTube session on what is HTML. Well, roughly you can understand that HTML for a web development is almost the same as what a bonus to your body. HTML is the one which defines the core structure of your web page or your website. So I don't think that I should be telling you that it's the very first thing that you must learn before drilling down to web development and creating your first web page or website. But before we proceed any further and learn more about HTML, let's have a quick look at today's agenda for this session. So I'll start this session by giving you a fair understanding of what is HTML. And we'll also discuss about the myth or the misconceptions related to HTML, which I guess most of you have in your mind. Once I'm done with it, I'll tell you about how web pages and websites are designed and where HTML, CSS, and JavaScript fits themselves into it. Okay? Now, once you guys are comfortable with this part, then we'll move ahead and learn about how you can write your first HTML codes to create a very basic web page. In this part, I'll tell you about various tags and attributes which you will use to create and structure your web page. All right? Once done with it, in the next part of HTML implementation, I'll show you how Edureka WordPress blogs uses HTML and what happens if you change any of the tag. All right? And finally, we'll end our session with some FAQs and doubt which I have come across from different learners. I hope the agenda is clear to you guys. Okay. So let's start with what is HTML? Well, HTML is a markup language which was developed by Tim Berners-Lee to create the electronic document which most of you refer to as pages or web pages. Let me just expand the letter of HTML for a better understanding. Well, the word HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Hypertext is a method by which you can move around the web by clicking on special text called hyperlinks, which brings you to the next page. Well, the fact that it is hyper, it just means that it is not linear. That is, you can go to any place on the internet whenever you want just by clicking on the links. All right, next comes the M part. M stands for markup. Well, markup is what HTML tags do to the text inside them. They mark it as a certain type of text like italicized text or bold text or anything. So basically, the markup deals with structuring your web page in a specific format. All right. So HTML is called Hypertext Markup Language because it is a language that allows the user to improve the appearance of and link text with the data on the internet. I hope now you guys have a fair idea of what is HTML. So how many of you are planning to add it in your resume under the section of programming language, you know? Yeah, it seems most of you. So HTML is a programming language. Is this what you have been thinking till now? Well, I'm sorry to tell you guys, but all of you who thought that it's a programming language are wrong. HTML is definitely a language, but it's not a programming language. Generally, a programming language is the one which allows you to describe some sort of process of doing something, right? Whereas on the other hand, HTML is a way of adding context and structure to the text. Always remember, HTML is not a programming language. It's a hypertext markup language. So from next time when you are preparing a CV, don't add HTML under the section of programming language known. I hope now all of us agree to it and are on the same page. Okay. So let's move ahead and let me show you guys some of the application of HTML which you guys come across in your day-to-day life. Let me just open some website, www.amazon.com. Okay, so this is how the first page of Amazon looks like. The visual which you see is a combination of HTML and CSS. Let me show you the skeleton of this web page, or let me show you how the page would look if I remove all these styles from it. Let me just remove it, disable all styles. Okay, done. So this is how your Amazon.com would look like if I remove all these styles from it. So there's a raw HTML version of Amazon.com. All right, so let's come back to our discussion. Generally, the website which you see is a collection of multiple web pages which is made using the combination of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. The skeleton of the page is made using HTML. The designing part is added using the CSS. And finally, JavaScript is used to make your website more interactive. I hope now you guys have a basic idea of what HTML is and where does it fit into the web page or website development. So I guess we can move ahead and discuss about how does it work. So inside this, we'll be discussing about HTML tags. So let's move ahead and see what's in it. So here's an example of basic HTML code. Well, I've written this code in my Notepad++, but you guys can write down in your Notepad, or even you can use IDEs like Atom or brackets. Well, as you can see, these short codes over here, these are known as tags. These words between angular bracket are known as HTML tags. Okay, they're used to label pieces of content such as heading, paragraph, or even it allows some of the cool stuff like adding images and table to your web page, or to tell your browser what to render on the page and whatnot. Obviously, different tags perform different functions. Don't worry, we'll discuss about them in detail in our next video on HTML tutorial. For now, just understand that HTML tags normally comes in pair, like p and slash p. Okay, the first tag in the pair is the start tag, and the second tag is the end tag. The only difference between the end tag and start tag is the forward slash symbol. It's like the end tag is written just like the start tag, but only the forward slash symbol is inserted before the tag name. Okay, fine. So now that you know what an HTML tag is, let's see whether you can understand this simple HTML code or not. Let me discuss each line of the code one by one. So starting with exclamation mark doc type HTML. So what does this mean? Well, if you're mentioning this tag, it means that you're defining your document to be of HTML5, or in other words, you're going to use HTML5 version. Okay. The next line is, or the next tag is HTML tag. As you can see, there is no forward slash symbol, so it is a opening tag. So our next tag is HTML. This is the root element of the HTML page. This tag specifies that from here the page starts. Okay. Next comes the body tag. Inside this body tag, we specify all the visible content on the page. We specify all the visible page content. Okay. Next comes the H1 tag. H1 tag is a header tag and is used to define a large heading. All right. There are multiple header tags like H1, H2, H3, H4, and so on. All right. So as you can see here, I have closed my H1 tag with forward slash H1. This means that my first header or headline. So this thing would be treated as my first heading. Okay. Next comes the p tag. The p defines a paragraph. So after headline, what do you do? You guys just go ahead and write the paragraph inside it, right? So below h1 comes the p tag. Well, it's not necessary, but generally the paragraph comes after the header. Okay, so whatever you have to write inside the paragraph, just mention it within the start and end tag of the paragraph. Okay, then finally what we did, we closed the body tag and the html tag. Okay, let me just write this code in my notepad and show you how does it actually work. Let me just open my notepad++. All right, so let's create a new file. So starting tag, since I am writing the HTML5 code, so my first tag would be exclamation mark doc type HTML. All right, next what I want to do, I want to define a HTML tag. Next would be your body tag. Inside that we'll define what are the visible page content. All right. So inside body, what I'll do first, I'll define my first header. So let's define H1 header. So inside that, I'll mention like, this is my first headline. All right. And I'll close this tag by forward slash H1. Done. After specifying my headline, I'll write some paras under it. So let's define our paragraph. Starting tag, like, this is my first paragraph. All right. Let's close this as well, slash P. Let's close the body. Let's close the HTML and done. So now that you have written your HTML code, your next step would be to save your code with extension of .html. So let's click on save. Instead of normal text file, select .html, hypertext markup language file. Inside that, just rename the folder. I'll rename it to like basic.html and I'll save it. So now when you'll go back to the save location and open the basic.html file, you'll see that your file opens into your default browser. But as you can see here, the browser is only showing the content without their respective tags. There is no tag like H1 tag or P tag in it, right? You're just seeing the content over here. So these browsers do not display the HTML tags, but what it does, it reads the file and translates the text into a visible form, thereby using them to render the content of the page. All right. Well, if you're practicing it along, let me just congratulate you on creating your very first web page. Yeah, guys, you heard me right. This is your web page. Let me just show you the very first web page that was ever created. Let's search for it. First web page ever created. So as you can see here, the Google found me this. The first web page went live on August 6, 1991. It was dedicated to information on World Wide Web project that was made by Tim Berners-Lee. It ran on the NEXT computer at the European Organization for Nuclear Research at CERN. The first web page address was, I guess, this. Let's see if it still works or not. Cool. So this web page is still working. Can you see how basic this web page is? Well, this was the very first web page that was ever created. Well, there's a very basic web page comparing to what we have right now. Currently, if you see the web page, it consists of this type of animation, that type of animation, SVG image, PNG image, and many other plugins and add-ons on the web page or website, right? So don't worry about that. So once you're done with going through the entire playlist of web development, I can assure you that you would definitely be able to create a dynamic and interactive web page for yourself. Okay, for now, let me just come back to our topic. Let's not deviate from it. So for now, let's just focus on what is HTML. Later on, step by step, we'll move ahead. All right, let's move ahead and see what's next. So the next comes HTML tags attribute. So what are these HTML tag attributes? Well, one last thing to know about tags is attributes. These attributes define special features of a tag. If tags are windows and doors, then attributes specify the specific building detail. This could be the width and height of the frame, or whether the window opens, or if the door has a lock. It's that kind of attribute which I'm talking about. All right. Well, attributes are always included inside the opening tag. Like one example is present on your screen. Well, we are defining here a tag. This a tag is basically used for hyperlink. Using this, you can hyperlink your text to any other link. In other words, if the user click on that hyperlink text, he'll be redirected to another website or any other web page, whatever you have linked to. Let's consider this for example. A space href. This href is an attribute name. What you're doing, you're defining an attribute. And the value of attribute is what? www.edureka.co. All right. So this entire thing, a href equal www.edureka.co inside quotes. This tag is your opening tag. All right. And what you have mentioned, like href equal www.edureka.co, this is your attribute. And after that, what are you doing? You're specifying the text which has to be hyperlinked with www.edureka.co. And finally, you're closing the tag. So once you are done with it and you open this in your web page, you'll see that you'll get a hyperlink text. Let me show you with an example that would make things more clear to you. Like, yeah, doc type HTML body. This would be common. Let me just add a tag over here. After that, let's specify an attribute name. For me, I'll use href. You can give any name to your attribute. All right. Next, what I'll do, I'll specify the attribute value for it. For me, it is https://www.edureka.co. Close this. Okay. So there's my starting tag. Then finally, what I'll do, I'll define my subject line. Like, click here to learn more. All right. And then what I'll do, I'll close my A tag. Fine. Let's save it. So as you can see here, we got our hyperlink text. Click here to learn more. Let's click it. Let's see whether it is redirecting to the website or not. So yeah, it is definitely redirecting me to www.edureka.co. So we have just created a very basic web page with some hyperlink text on it. Okay, now that we have covered about the basic of HTML in this what is HTML session, let me just show you the HTML structure of our blog. This will give you the idea of actual implementation of HTML in industries to create a web page. Well, we at Edureka, we use web page to write our blogs. WordPress is an open source software that you can use to create a beautiful website or blog. Currently, it is used by more than 60 million websites, including 30.6% of the top 10 million websites as of April 2018. Let me just show you how we guys at Edureka create our blog. /blog/admin. Let's add a new post. Let's add any name like HTML basic. And inside that, let me just write few lines like this is my first blog. Let's define a headline like what is HTML. Let's change it to heading one. All right. So as you can see here, we have heading one, heading two, three, four, five, and six. So next part would be to define the paragraph. So what is HTML? HTML is a hypertext markup language that is used to create a web page or a website. Okay, done. Fine. Let me show you how this looks like. Let's save it. And let's preview the basic blog that we have just created. So this is how your blog would look like. Like this was my headline. What is HTML? And under that, I defined that HTML is a hypertext markup language that is used to create a web page or a website. All right. So what if I want to make this HTML as bold? So let's add a tag over here, strong tag. strong HTML. That's it, not the entire sentence. So strong. So strong and forward slash strong. So now what do you think? What would be the bold part? Let's save it. Any guess, anyone? You know what? You'll be getting the entire statement as the bold. This was the original, right? So can you see this entire statement it changed to bold? And why? Because you mentioned strong at the starting and the end. So whatever would come under the start and close tag would be treated as bold. What if I just want to make HTML bold? So what I'll do, I'll just define a closing tag after HTML. Okay, and I'll remove this closing tag from here and let's save it. So currently you can see that HTML is a hypertext markup language. This entire line is bold. Let me just refresh it and show you what are the changes which we got. So yeah, so now you can see that only this HTML is bold. Rest other are normal text, right? So this was just one of the way of adding elements in our blog. All right. And now let's just move ahead and end our session with some of the FAQs and doubt which I have come across from different learners. So the first one is creating my web page going to take long? Well, remember the first HTML code that we wrote in our Notepad++ and open in our default browser? Well, that was also an example of a web page. It hardly took me a minute, right? So yeah, how long will it take to create a web page depends on what you want from your web page. Learning HTML will only take few days of reading and learning the code for what you want. Don't worry about the basics. In my next video, I'll teach you about it. And I'm sure if you'll practice it along, you'll surely learn it within an hour or two. So once you are done with the basics and you have a proper idea of the tags, you can easily start showcasing your creativity and creating HTML pages. All right, fine. So coming to the next question, do I have to be online at all the time while developing my web page? No, not at all. You can code your entire website offline by storing it all on your computer. And later then when you get your system connected to the internet, just transfer all this file to the web. Later in future, whenever you have new content, just add that to the existing online version of your site. It's really quite simple, right? Fine. Coming to the next question, is it possible to create a website without HTML? Well, the answer is yes as well as no, depending on what you mean by developing without HTML or CSS. If you mean that you don't have any notation of HTML and CSS, so therefore you don't know how to code a website. Well, if this was your question, then don't worry about that. There are plenty of services that allows you to build a website without any knowledge of HTML or CSS, like Squarespace, Wix, WordPress, and many more. But if you mean that ultimately you want a website that is not written in HTML and CSS, well, I'm sorry to tell you, but HTML, CSS, and JavaScript are the only language that a browser can use to render a website. You can develop a website in Python, PHP, or any other language, but ultimately, what those languages do is to create HTML and CSS. All right, you won't find any traces of those language in your final page. Well, JavaScript is a bit different because it can be used inside the page to trigger and play dynamics action like sending the data from a form, error or confirmation messages, images or content sliders, or any other dynamic interaction. So concluding this, I'll tell that your entire web page would consist of HTML as the main code and you can't do without it. All right. You can use CSS to express the style of the elements on the page, like color, shapes, shadows, transition, transparency, responsiveness, etc. And finally, JavaScript if you need any server communication and dynamic content. Is it clear now? Okay. So thank you guys. This was all for this session. See you soon in my next session on HTML tutorial. For now, in case you have any doubt, feel free to add your doubt in the comment section below. Thank you.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!